the studio bovine. Today we have Julia Ritvedt from the National Animal Disease Center in the US. Welcome in the studio.
Thank you.
You presented here about BVDV and the cousin, the Hobie-like viruses. Can you briefly explain what Hobie-like viruses are?
The disease caused by bovine viral diarrhea viruses is called bovine viral diarrhea, which is kind of a misnomer. It doesn't happen just in cattle. It can also happen in wildlife. It is caused by a virus, but the main symptom isn't diarrhea. It's immunosuppression, reproductive disease, and respiratory disease. That group of symptoms can also be caused by another virus, not just BVD1 or BVD2, but a new virus called Hobie-like virus, which is related to them. It belongs to the same genetic branch, but it's distant.
And how important is a virus?
The Hobie-like virus could do as much damage to as BVD1 or BVD2 does to a country. Currently, it's not as widespread as BVD1 or BVD2. It's found principally in South America, Southeast Asia, and India. But we think that if it would come into a country, it would do just as much damage as BVD1 and BVD2, and we don't have vaccines against it. And we don't have commercial products for diagnosing it.
So that's a challenge. What is your recommendation? Like, how can we prevent it will enter the countries where it's not yet?
We need to get busy developing some diagnostics that can be made commercially available so people can find it. We need to be doing screening for it as we do trade in cattle and in bovine products. And we also need to develop some vaccines against it so that when they talk about a BVD eradication program, it should be understood that an eradication program, to eradicate the disease, you have to get rid of BVD1, BVD2, and Hobie-like viruses.
Yeah, you tell there's no like a commercial diagnosis tool. Who do you think should take up that role to develop it?
The same countries now that are making the diagnostics for the BVD1 and BVD2 that are used in the official programs for the different countries, we would hope would start picking up the work of making the Hobie-like virus diagnostics.
And the fact that in a lot of European countries they're working towards BVD eradication, does that also mean like if those herds are naive for BVDV, that it would open the door more for viruses like Hobie-like viruses?
Absolutely, because right now there's a little bit of cross-protection between BVD 1 and 2 and Hobie-like virus. If we make completely naive herds in an eradication process and you aren't checking for Hobie-like virus, it does get introduced, you have the perfect situation for an economic storm, and that these animals are all naive and you're going to start having some really substantial losses due to Hobie-like virus.
And what animals can be affected by it?
So far, it's been detected in the field in cattle and in water buffalo. So we're not sure if it originated in water buffalo or that just happens to be a finding. In the laboratory, we can infect sheep, goats, and pigs with it.
Okay. My final question is, like, a lot of veterinarians are going to watch this video. What is your take-home message, what they could do right away?
Just to understand that when you talk about BVD eradication, it isn't just eradication of BVD1 and BVD2. You also have to eradicate Hobie-like viruses also, and make sure that you know what it is, and that the people who are designing the eradication programs are paying attention to this.
Thank you very much for your insights.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching Studio Bovine, and hope to see you again.